Hi, this is FernGZCarr. Welcome to the Centrifugal Eye Smell Interview. For more free resources to help and entertain you, please be sure to click like and subscribe. Enjoy this nostalgic, fun, and smelly retrospective of my contributor's interview from the Nose Like a Cherry issue of the Centrifugal Eye. Questions and answers are provided here with kind permission of interviewer and TCE editor Eve Hannanen. What's the most pervasive scent or odor in your daily life? Happily, the most pervasive scent or odor in my daily life is the smell of fresh air. Have you ever had a smell remind you of another person, place, or event? How about the reverse? Has a person, place, or event ever conjured up a scent in memory? Or have you ever had an aroma trigger a déjà episode? Describe the smell and the situation you thought you'd experienced before. The dentist's office always seems to have a strange smell associated with it. I wondered why this was always vaguely disconcerting. A quick internet search came up with the answer. Apparently, the smell comes from formalcresol, metacresol acetate, eugenol, and the odor of drilled teeth. This combination triggers the brain's limbic system, which is responsible for emotion. Bottom line, I think that at the conclusion of every dental visit, adults, not just children, should be entitled to a prize from the treasure chest. What one person do you associate most with a particularly distinct scent? A friend of mine has a tendency to douse herself in perfume. Ordinarily, this isn't really an issue. However, in the confines of a car, a gas mask could come in very handy. I'll give you a subject, and you tell me what scent or odor you associate with it. The most recent holiday. For New Year's Eve, I bought a bottle of wine in conjunction with a fundraiser for the Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals. The wine was called Cat's Pee on a Gooseberry Bush, but it had a delicate citrus herbal aroma, contrary to what its name would suggest. The last thing you opened, unlocked, or unwrapped. My husband accidentally left his car on after taking groceries into the house from our attached garage. The engine is very quiet. 7 hours and half a tank of gas less later, I open the garage door to the smell of car exhaust. Your favorite place to write? My favorite place to write is in my office with my dog at my side. When it's not too cold, I'll open the window and have a fresh breeze drift into the room. The last poem you remember reading? I read Marianne Moore's syllabic first poem, The Fish. Although it should have conjured up smells of the briny deep, it didn't have that effect. I was taken instead by its visual imagery, in particular her description of, quote, submerged shafts of the sun split like spun glass, unquote. Name a favorite poet. What scent would you assign that poet? Why? Wordsworth, definitely daffodils. Interestingly enough, in his poem, Daffodils, he makes no reference to their scent. He focuses more on the visual, particularly the image of daffodils dancing. If you could turn any three words in the English language into a perfume, what would you concoct? I would concoct essence of skunk. I'm not a fan of perfume, and I think a name like that would pose a real marketing challenge. It would be interesting to see whether anyone would buy such a product. I believe they would. What odor turns you off the most? I recently bought some salon shampoo, which when mixed with water smelled like men's deodorant. The scent was tenacious. It lasted for days. I literally felt like a walking armpit. Many smells are hard to identify without other cues. Aromas can be even harder to describe to other people without resorting to cliché. Choose an unusual word or short phrase to describe the scent of each of the following. Pumpkin pie. A cornucopia of spice. Pine needles. Bracing. Winter. Anesthetized nostrils. When you're writing a poem, do you tend to include all the sensory detail in the first draft, or do you add it in on subsequent drafts? What's the hardest sense to capture in your writing? While I try to include all sensory detail in my first draft, I often will supplement it in subsequent drafts. Personally, the hardest sense to capture is the olfactory. I don't tend to possess the world's greatest sense of smell, which can be a blessing at times, so I generally don't tend to focus too much on that in my writing. When I do, I have to ensure that it doesn't appear to be contrived. What other sense besides smell do you rely on most for evoking detail in your writing? Because I don't possess a keen sense of smell, I would have to say that I tend to rely equally upon my visual and auditory senses. I wonder if that's analogous to a blind person, for example, who has developed a keener sense of hearing as compensation. When you hear the word lemon, what's the first associative memory that comes up? Describe in 2 to 6 sentences. Without a millisecond's hesitation, the first thing that comes to mind is lemon meringue pie, she wrote with a snicker. My mother and aunt are positively Pavlovian over it. Like Roman gladiators, they'd probably engage in a fight to the finish for the last piece. Okay, I'll admit that is hyperbole. My mother and aunt are very polite, sweet people, but they do love their lemon pie. Hey everyone, thanks very much for watching. For more free writing resources to help and entertain you, please be sure to click subscribe. My poetry book, Shards of Crystal, is available worldwide at retail bookstores and libraries via Ingram iPage and from Amazon.